tarnish the horrific criminal case of a 20...
Deputy.
The horrific criminal case of a 26-year-old man who has pleaded guilty to grooming girls as young as 9 has shocked the country. It follows a number of recent cases and news reports on the types of harmful communications that new technology has enabled. This ranges from the appalling cases that we've just referenced to the insidious type of cyberbullying that's now a grave concern for many, many parents across the country, and the impact that revenge porn, so-called, has had on both men and women. Our laws are hopelessly out of date. There's rightly been a public demand for us to act in this House. The internet and social media is a wonder of human ingenuity and has brought people closer together, but clearly it has a dark side. In the vacuum of no clear government policy, where we had a Minister of State make a ludicrous suggestion that social media accounts should be tied to public service cards. In 2013, the then Minister for Communications, Pat Rabbit, set up an independent expert group on internet conduct and governance. Their report made a series of structural, legislative and administrative recommendations, including that the existing offences of sending messages which are grossly offensive, indecent, obscene or menacing should be updated to include obviously new forms of electronic communication. As the law stands, only phone and texts are covered. In 2016, the Law Reform Commission report on harmful communication and digital safety was published. They highlighted gaps in the criminal law, in particular in relation to newer forms of communication. Last year, the Labour Party published our Harassment, Harmful Communications and Related Offences Bill based on the Law Reform Commission report. Next Wednesday, we intend to bring that bill before this House in our own private members' time. However, the second part of the law reform recommendations, that we really needed a digital safety commissioner, is outside the scope of a private member's bill because it would be a charge on the state. The Irish Examiner reports today that the government will appoint a digital safety officer. This, I assume, will be one modelled on the Law Reform Commission report. However, the government's own legislative programme is silent on this matter. So, Minister, can I ask you just two simple questions? What exactly is the government proposing, and when will we see a digital safety officer in place on a statutory basis? And will you, in the interim, confirm that the government will support the much-needed reform outlined in the Law Reform Commission report that we have encompassed in the bill that we will bring before the House next week?
First of all, can I say that the government shares your concern in this area. As a politician, but also as a father of 3 girls who know how to use my mobile phone as well as I do, despite the fact that the oldest one of them is only 8, I think is results in a conversation in virtually every family in the country in terms of how do we get the balance right between allowing our children access technology and at the same time trying to protect them from the dangers of the exposure to grooming, cyberbullying, and explicit information and imagery and so on. This is a challenge that the government wants to respond to in a comprehensive way. Minister Nocton's position on the establishment of a digital safety commissioner has been widely reported, and he's currently exploring and consulting on the need, feasibility and requirements on the creation of the office of a digital safety commissioner. We haven't had the conversation, Deputy, in government yet in terms of what that's going to look like, what it's going to cost and when it's going to happen, but I expect we'll have that very soon. But I know that that Minister Nocton is committed to that course of action, and I suspect he'll get strong support across government for that. On Tuesday, the 21st of November, Minister Nocton convened a meeting with the Minister for Justice, Equality and the Minister for Children and Youth Affairs and their officials. The meeting covered online safety issues, including various initiatives taking place at a national and European level to tackle illegal and harmful content online. There is a planned open policy debate that will take place on the 8th of March in the Royal Hospital Kilmainham on this specific issue to try and develop and hopefully finalise government policy in the area. So we look forward to your private members next week to explore further how the Labour Party feels we can progress this issue.
Deputy Highland.
The Labour Party feel it's built upon the recommendations of the Law Reform Commission report. While, as I say, it's not within our power to propose the establishment of the Digital Safety Commissioner, we can, within the next few weeks, update our antiquated law to include the offences of sending grossly offensive, indecent, obscene or menacing communications to new modern technology. The Oireachtas already made that law in relation to older technologies, telephone and texting. Let's do that immediately. And then let's set about as quickly as we can putting a digital safety commissioner in place. The blueprint is there from the Law Reform Commission. Bluntly, I think the nation believes that the time for debating this is well past. It's 2016 since the Law Reform Commission made its recommendations. Really, it is now time for action.
I accept it's time for action. But I also accept that this maybe isn't as simple as some people might outline. I'm not suggesting that we ignore the Law Reform Commission recommendations, but I am saying that this is an international problem as well as a national one. A lot of the imagery that children and indeed adults are exposed to online doesn't actually come from Ireland. It comes from further afield, and we do need to look, I think, at the responsibility of those who are responsible for online platforms in terms of how we can screen and remove inappropriate information and how we can protect people in an appropriate way while at the same time ensuring that we enjoy the benefits of technology. And this is a difficult balance to get right, and I think most Western democracies are struggling with it. So the point I'm making is that there are practical, sensible things that we can do quickly, and I look forward to Minister Nocton bringing recommendations to government. As I say, I think he'll get strong support from the Taoiseach down.